What's up, guys? It's been a minute since I made my last video. Straight truth, for those of you that don't know, about 2 months ago, the FTC started imposing COPPA laws on YouTube, and as a result of that, there was like a $170 million lawsuit against the company, or rather, it was a settlement. Part of that settlement, though, was that they essentially threw creators to the wolves and said that FTC could do just about whatever they wanted to them. And the way the COPPA laws shake out is that any video that is targeting children under the age of 13 can no longer have comments, can no longer be searchable, can't be monetized. It's an absolute clusterfuck. After that came down the pipe, a lot of creators thought that YouTube was going to try and, step in, maybe be like, hey, come on, do something, anything, put up some kind of a fight. But really, though, the government was just too big. YouTube's kind of too small by comparison, and they really, really kind of couldn't do anything. And after that, after watching dozens of channels get demonetized and, the threats of a $40,000+ fine per citation, I was like this close, like maybe like a micrometer away, itty bitty bitty tiny distance from completely deleting my YouTube channel. The only reason I've decided not to was a really long time subscriber since the beginning, and even before then a little bit, reached out to me and said, YouTube is your main platform. It's where so many guys learn about the Angio methods, learn about your work, and it would be devastating to the male community if you left YouTube. And even after he told me that, I was really still on the fence because, let's be honest, the COPPA law shit's scary. It's really scary. A lot of creators are already talking about abandoning the platform. But after I sat down, kind of let the anxiety of it all wash out, and I looked at my analytics, my main demographic, counting where all of my views are coming from, is about 18 years old to about mid-40s. With the absolute most views being in the 25 to 35, years of age range. So given that, I've decided to keep my YouTube channel going, and I will begin regularly uploading once more. I am gonna try and do videos once a week. Life's been a little hectic recently, but that's life. That's kind of how it is. If you're alive, it's going to be hectic. So, besides all of that fun stuff, why have I decided to make a YouTube video today? Alrighty, guys. So, being in research and design, being a vascular researcher, really sitting down and just looking at mechanics, it's very, very difficult to make a lot of impactful or great videos in a row. It's almost something you really can't do. There's got to be a little bit of a downtime, a little bit of a lag. And recently, well, there's been a lot of lag, and the reason why is I've been designing a brand new Angio wheel. Now, this is going to look fairly similar to my other designs, but with a couple noted changes. Ladies and gentlemen, mostly gentlemen, allow me to introduce to you the Angio Wheel V4, aka what I've called, the Flowmaster. Alrighty. Now, the main difference between this wheel, Angio Wheel V4, and the standard Angio Wheel V3 is that instead of the handle being located on this side and the little turning device right here being located on this side, it's a flip. Now, you're probably wondering, why on earth have I flipped this wheel around? Straight truth, about a month and a half, almost 2 months ago, my gains came to a crashing halt, totally halted. And I was really struggling. I was really struggling to figure out why have my gains halted? You know, why am I not seeing as good of erections as I normally do? Why am I seeing reduced fullness? You know, even in the face of eating properly, even in the face of getting great sleep, doing, you know, full body cardio, why on earth are, you know, my great erections dropping off? What the fuck's going on, right? So I didn't even think of this as a potential reason, but here we go. Okay, so as the arterial networks develop, as the corpus spongiosum develops a more rich, abundant, you know, larger arterial network, it will actually become more resistant to fluid displacement. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. You know, it stays more, you know, puffed up and full, and you know, you can more easily manipulate the blood within its chambers. However, because it's remaining so full, the original Angio Wheel, the standard, you know, version 3 that had this handle mounted over here, you know, on this side, the flip, it wasn't actually applying enough compression to cause the fluid displacement it needed to. What I was basically doing is I was finding I had to really, really press down and get these rollers right here to dig into the corpus spongiosum to restore that fluid displacement that I'd come to love and, you know, really just, wow, to get them super fat woodies that I absolutely love. Well, after I, you know, sat down, looked at the design, flipped the handle over, you know, I made a couple improvements. This is actually an updated axle design right here. It's a lot more smooth rolling. I mean, before you could hear a little bit of a whistle because it was actually riding on threads, but I have since found handle blanks, or rather bolt blanks, and I have machined them myself to create an extremely smooth rolling, very, very, very smooth rolling axle design. I love it. I really love it. It's good shit now. The other thing, a lot of guys were complaining about the handle was too difficult to assemble once they got the Angio Wheel. So, on top of doing the custom machining, you know, since I'm doing that now, I could get it to just the right length so that way we can use a wing nut and you can actually get a little bit of a better grip whenever you're holding it for digging into the corpus spongiosum. Really nice touch there. Yeah. So, how have things progressed? You know, now that I've switched the handle over, you know, done a little bit of configurations, you know, not too much, but, you know, enough to really count, what's the verdict? Well, I have never in my life experienced fatter or more persistent erections. I mean, truly, I really was underestimating how much compression I would have to apply, you know, how much downward force I would have to apply in order to keep fluid displacement occurring at the rate that I wanted at high rotation. You see, as this wheel spins up, the amount of resistance that the corpus spongiosum is going to exert, you know, that's going to, offer, is going to go way, way up. And I didn't really understand that at first. I mean, it's obviously, you know, it's very, very straightforward, but it, you know, this is all new territory. You know, I've never had erections this big before. I've never had, you know, a corpus spongiosum or corporeal chambers as full before. It was really a totally new experience. So, you know, obviously just blah. But, yeah, no, since this switch, the fattest, hardest, most vascular erections of my life, and I mean of my entire life, Okay, so we've all seen, like, the cheesy exercise commercials, like, oh, I'm in the best shape of my life, you know, it's some guy in, like, his 70s, you know, on the treadmill or whatever. You know, I really expected that as I got older as a male that, you know, there would be physical heights that I would never see again, and holy fucking God, I was wrong. I was dead fucking wrong. I was so thankfully wrong. I mean, the erections, the quality, the fullness, the fatness that I'm experiencing, the erections I experienced as a teenager in the absolute prime of my youth, they cannot in any way, shape, or form even attempt to hold a candle to what I am experiencing now. As a male that is on the cusp of 30, I am quite literally having the absolute, completely and totally best erections of my life. And it's a dream come true. I mean, it almost made me cry a little bit because I was really worried that, you know, my research had come to its, you know, conclusion. You know, like I said, I just expected as I would get older that, you know, certain things would slowly, you know, become, you know, physically out of my reach. You know, that was something I was really worried about, you know, is that it was taking too long for my research to ramp up. It was taking too long for my work to, you know, really get off the ground. And I was so worried that I would find, you know, all the answers I wanted in life, and then I would be too old to appreciate them. And, you know, this journey with the Angion methods and now the Angio Wheel is just showing me how true that belief was not, you know, that even being an older male, even, you know, steadily aging up, you know, I can still physically improve. And that just hits, you know, it hits me right here. And I'm sure it's probably hitting you too, right there, you know, that's not too late. You know, it's not too late to achieve the goals that you want, you know, to reach the fullness, the size, the quality, the functionality that you've always wanted. It's not too late. And, you know, for me, that was powerful. Saying all that, however, you know, getting all that out of the way, you know, having my heart to heart with you guys, there are some realities with this new design. And let me cover that. Okay, so, oh man, teared up just a little bit there. Just need a moment. With this new design, and I am going to be including this in the instruction manual, all right, because you can apply so much more downward force on the corpus spongiosum and you can maintain fluid displacement even at high rotation, it is extremely, let me make this very clear, extremely important that you do not try to spin this thing up rapidly right away. You really seriously want to slowly ramp up your rate of rotation. Okay, now the reason why I'm making explicit mention of this is because since with this design you're able to maintain the level of fluid displacement that you really need at high rotation, this thing is moving a fuck ton more blood through the bulbodorsal circuit. What that means is that if you spin this bad boy up too quickly, all right, and you don't give your vascular networks time to adjust to that rate of flow, you can actually blow a sinusoidal capillary, which is exactly what happened to me with my glands. I experienced a very nasty blood blister. I am happy to report, however, that after 2 weeks of healing, I am completely fine. But seriously, to avoid anything like that, you know, a blown out sinusoidal space in the glands or other such issues, rotate this bad boy up, all right, nice and slow. Over about a 20-30 minute session, steadily ramp up, okay? Steadily. Don't just get in there and be like, all right, let's do this. No, don't do that, okay? Nice and steady ramp ups, all right? It's just like any other form of aerobic exercise, right? You don't want to just start into the sprinting. You don't want to just start going balls to the walls. You want to warm up a little bit, right? So warm up, Start at the lower rates of rotation. Steadily work your way up. All right? Good. Next thing. Next big thing. Having just finished designing this new Angio wheel, something else is coming around the corner. Something that a lot of guys are already probably anticipating or maybe even, you know, experiencing the cringe like, oh God, it's coming. It's Valentine's Day on the 14th. Given that, after a lot of mulling it over, I have decided from today until Valentine's Day to run a free domestic shipping sale. So if you are in America and you have already progressed through the hand-based Angion methods and you really want to get in on the ground floor, like the new era, the next era of bodybuilding, and try the Angio wheel, now's the time to do it. I understand that most likely, you know, the guys that I'm tempting are going to be from the far-flung corners, like from New York or Maine or out in California. So I expect, you know, to see like shipping and handling rates of like 20 plus, you know, or maybe even $30+ and fully accepting that. But yes, free domestic shipping with this coupon offer code. You can also click on the link in the description and it will lead you straight to my Etsy page and will automatically apply that discount. So if for this Valentine's Day, you want to skip the chocolate, you want to skip the flowers, the shitty dates that nobody really likes, and you just want to get to the good hard fucking that you know your girl deserves, then why don't you hop on over, get yourself an Angio wheel today. Yeah. Well, guys, that's it for this week's video. As always, I'm your host, Janus, signing off.